I wanted my 8-month-old to have a Montessori dressing area to start to learn the value of independence and maybe just learn some skills and get used to having in her bedroom. So this was the simple design that I created. Out of the scraps of wood that were left over, I made this simple toy that's good for color recognition as well as shape recognition. I'm not a neutrals person and I wanted the wood to have a little bit of a rough look. So here you have it, but I think that it's a hit with her.
Ada nak berapa cukup dia pisang? Dua ke tiga? Hai. Ada berapa? Dua ke tiga? Oh, Mama dapat wavephone tu pagi juga lah. Terima kasih wavephone.
My son goes to Montessori preschool and every week they have a show and tell of an item starting with a letter from the alphabet. So I decided to create weekly Montessori inspired activities for him to take to show and tell. For letter D, we created a dirty dino to work on his fine motor skills.
You popped it out.
It's called
a purple heart.
A purple heart. Well, over here.
You found a match. You did it.
Okay. In a wrap.
If you have a preschool child who can't do puzzles yet, then try this fall activity. For toddlers, you often need to first introduce them to the concept of whole and halves. want to raise an independent toddler.
I gave Jonah another difficult task today, and I had him make a peanut butter and jelly. I set up all of the ingredients so that he can make it independently. You'll notice the first thing he does is get a knife and a plate, and he attempted to spread the peanut butter with the knife and just realized it was not working. So he self-corrected and decided to get a spoon instead. As you can see, the spoon worked out much better for him. After he spread the peanut butter, he washed off his spoon, and then he used the same spoon to spread the jelly. You can see that that also was not working out well for him, so he self-corrected and just poured it on. You'll notice I did not correct anything that he did with his sandwich. If I were to spread it out more or fix anything, that would give him the idea that his job wasn't good enough. Here you'll see he tried to use the spoon to scoop up the blueberries and realized it wasn't working, so he just picked them up with his hands and put them in the strainer. Here he's moving the utensils out of the sink so that he could wash his blueberries. So this video is a great example that children are capable of self-correction and they understand more than we give them credit for. He can tell when something wasn't working and corrected it without me having to say anything.